Hello everybody, we'll talk today about background of probability to be used in our queuing systems later on and modeling. We'll talk about finite probability, complement, union and intersection, assigning probability, conditional probability, and last, independence probability, okay? Let's start by finite probability. We'll define some parameters before we begin. An experiment in a procedure, it yields one of a given set of all possible outcomes. Okay, we have S, sample space of the experiment is the set of possible outcome. So how many possible results we will have in any problem, in any experiment, we'll call it S. Also, we have an event parameter. Event is a subset of S. You know subset what is. All the elements of the event must be included in all the elements in the space. Okay? Event is a subset of the sample space. By Laplace definitions, the equation will be the probability of event equal number of event, of course positive number, divided by number of space. Okay? Example. We have Earl contains 4 blue balls and 5 red balls. What is the probability that a ball chosen will be blue? Okay, this is the first simple questions. How many balls we have? We have total balls in the urn equal 9. So we have 9 possible outcomes. So S will be equal to 9. Are you understand this? And from this 9 possible outcome, we have 4 blue balls. So the event in this example will be E equal 4. Event of existing blue ball is 4. The space of all, the summation of all the balls will be S equal to 9. So the probability will be PE equal E over S, 4 over 9. Are you understand this? It's simple equation. Are you okay?
Yes, well.
Yes.
Okay. Now, how many probability to get, what is the probability to get a red ball will be if we...
5 over 9.
5 over 9. We have another solution, if you want, graphically solution. You can draw your problem as a graph, as set, subset, subset, S is the set, R, red, blue, red balls will be subset of S, and B, blue balls, 4 balls here, will be all sets, subset of the set S, okay? So we have probability of a blue, 4 over 9, probability of red, 5 over 9, okay? It's easy. Now, if we pick 2 balls from the urn successfully without replacing, focus on this point, without replacing, okay? So what is the probability that the second ball is red, given that the first is also red? What is the probability to get first one red and the second one also red? The equation of probability will be times, will multiply these two probabilities. So we'll first begin with probability of first red, times probability of the second ball red also. So probability of the first red will be verified if you, 5 over 9, okay, times, now if we took one ball red, how many balls will be in the air? كم طابة بيبقى بالعلبة إذا شلنا واحدة حمراء؟ كم طابة حيبقى؟ الأس الجديدة قد بتصير؟ شو بتساوي الأس الجديدة؟ 8 تسعة هن كلهم تسعة طابات، شلنا منهم طابة حمراء حيصير عدد الطابات كلهم 8 صح؟
صح
أوكي، وعدد الطابات الحمراء المتبقية قد إيه حتكون؟
كمان بدها تقل وحدة كمان أربعة
أربعة، لأنه كانوا خمسة راد، شلنا منهم وحدة راد بأول iteration بأول chosen، صار في عنا أربعة رد وثمانية كأس، صار في عنا أس جديدة ورد جديد. So the second probability of the second rad depend what happened in the first time. So 5 over 9 balls times 5 minus 1 because we pick one red ball over a new s prime equal s minus 1 also 8 ball will be the probability will be 5 over 18. Did you get it? فهمتوا السؤال مظبوط؟ الو
يس دكتور
اوكي it's easy let's go further example 2. What is the probability that when two dice are rolled, زهرين عم نكبوا مع بعض، عنا زهر وعم نكبوا مع بعض، زهرين مثل بلعبة الطاولة. What is the probability that the sum of the numbers on the two dice is 7؟ مكبينا زهرين، شو ال probability إنه يطلعوا 7؟ شو ال probability يطلعوا 7؟ أوكي؟ وهيدا على كل حال هيدا الزهر بيعملوا gambling عليه قمار وبيراهنوا عليه. في ناس بيراهنوا عليها بالكازونيات بهالطريقه البروبابيليتي اوكي فسبعه هو الهايست بروبابيليتي تو جيت 7 7 از ذا هايست بروبابيليتي ذان اذرز فاليوز اوكي سوليوشن هاو ماني نمبرز وي هاف فور بوث دايسز فور ايتش دايس هاز 6 نمبرز فروم 1 تو 6 Because we have two dice, so we multiply 6 times 6. Okay? So we have big space, all combination, all possible outcomes will be 36. Okay? Now, we want to get 7 from these two dice. So there are 6 outcomes that their sum is 7, which are if we have 1 and 6. 2 and 5, 3 and 4, 4 and 3, 5 and 2, 6 and 1. So we have 6 outcomes that sums will be 7. Sorry, sums 7. We have E here equal to 6. 6 possible outcomes from 36 outcomes. So the probability will be 6 over 36 equal 1 over 6. Okay? Any question here? Any question here?
No.
Okay, good. Now we'll talk about complement. Theorem, what is the complement of probability? If we have E event in the sample space S, the probability of E bar complement of E is given by probability of E bar equal 1 minus probability of E. Okay, it's simple. Example, a sequence of 10 bits in randomized generated. What is the probability that at least one of these bits is 0. Okay? We have 10 bits, random. What is the probability that at least one of these bits is 0? What is the probability at least one of these bits is 0? We have two solutions. If we use the complement solution, will be E, event of E, will be at least one of the bits is zero. So E bar will be the complement of at least will be that all the bits are ones. You got it in the logic? If E, the event that at least one of the 10 bits is zero, so E bar will be, all the bits will be ones. That's the complement of E. So because the sample space S is a set of all bits string of 10 lengths, so S will be equal 2 to the power 10, S will be 2 to the power 10, all the combinations of 10 bits, then E bar will be only one, because we have only one iteration, one combination will be equal to all ones. Okay? So the probability will be PE equal 1 minus P E bar equal 1 minus E bar will be one iteration, one combination, because all the ones is only one, over S, which equal 2 to the power 10, summation 1023 over 1024. Okay? This is the solution using complement. Or the simplest way, solution 2 will be, for any combination of 2 power n, which is S, there is only one combination that all the bits are ones, and the other combinations at least has one bit is zero. Okay? Here, E equal S minus one, because all the combination of the bits will be zero, like example 2 bits, example 2 bits, 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. We have 4 combination. 1 1 is 1/4. The other 3 include zeros. 0 0 0 1 1 0 include at least 1 0s. So to get all the ones is one, only one combination. So E here for at least 0 combination will be equal S minus 1. So the equation here without complement, without using complement, 2 to the power n minus 1 over 2 to the power n equal 2 power 10 minus 1 over 2 power 10, the same result will give us. Okay? Fimtu hada? Did you understand these examples? Between this solution and this solution? Any question on this?
No. Take an example, like briefly.
Let's repeat it. If we use...
أول واحد فهمته تمام كثير.
The first one you understand it?
هل complement فهمته الثاني بس.
هذا أصعب من أول من الثاني. هذا أصعب. أوكي. Solution الثاني حنرجع نعيد. If you have 2 bits, if you have 2 bits, example, if you have 2 bits, we have 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. Okay? Okay. 2 to the power 4, 2 to the power 2 equal 4 combination. 2 to the power 2. So we have in all the combination or orbits, we have only one combination that all the will be ones. The others will be zeros. At least one of them zeros, at least. Okay? So if we have S here in this example, S is equal to 4, 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 2 equal to 4 equal S. Okay?
So.
Okay. E here, the event here that has at least one zeros, at least one zero, will be the others, the other combination, all the other combination, all the other combination, because all the other combination has at least zero. Only one combination that has all ones in all examples, okay? So E will be, always will be S minus one. Here, this example will be equal to 3, okay? The same in 2 power 10. We have S equal to 2 power 10, big S. We have only one combination that all is ones or are ones, okay? So the event here in that example will be S minus one. L E equal S minus one. All the combination minus one. So we'll have S minus one will be 2 power 10 minus 1 over 2 power 10. We'll get this value. Did you understand now?
Yes, I did. Merci.
Okay. Let's move. Okay. Let's continue. Okay, now we'll talk about union and intersection. Okay. كلكم اخذتوا discrete structures. Okay, union or intersection. كلكم معكم خبر فيهم صحيح؟ الو؟
ايه كلنا بنعرفهم.
Okay, كثير منيح. If we have two events in the sample S, if you have two events in the sample S, then probability of event one union event two equal to probability of event one plus probability of event two minus probability of intersection between E1 and E2. Okay, this is theory. Example. What is the probability that a positive number selected at random from the set of positive integers between 1 and 100, okay, is divisible by either 2 or 5? We have either 2 or 5. Okay, so we have here two events. Divisible by 2 and event 1 will be the event that integer is divisible by 2, and event 2 will be the event that divisible by 5. Okay? So E1 union E2 will be the event that is divisible by either 2 or 5. We have two events, E1 divisible by 2, which equal, if we have list or array from 1 to 100, what is the number of E1 here? What is the number of E1? What is the numbers of event E1 if we divisible by 2? All
50,
because we have 50 even number, 50 odd number, okay? From 1 to 100, we have equally here, 50 even number, 50 odd number. So E1 will be 50, right? E2, what will be?
20,
because we have from 1 to 100 divided by 5, we have 20 element or 20 numbers or integer divisible by 5, which are the multiple of 5. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, till 100. So we have 20 integer that divisible by 5. Okay? Now, the intersection. What is the intersection? If we E1 enter E2 is the event that is divisible by both at the same time, by 2 and by 5 at the same time, so will be divisible by product of these two, 10. Did you understand this? E1 enter E2 is the event that is divisible by both 2 and 5 at the same time. So will be divisible by 10. What is the number of E1 intersection E2 will be 100 divisible by 10 equal 10. Did you get at this? فهمتوا هذه الفكرة? Are you understand why E1 equal 50, E2 equal 20, and the intersection equal 10?
Yes.
حدا؟ Okay, good. Good. Now, we'll apply this equations. Okay? P, E1 union E2 equal the probability of E1, 50 over 100. Probability of E2, 20 over 100. Minus probability intersection, which is 10 over 100, which equal all 3 over 5. Okay? 3 over 5. This problem, this exercise or example, because we have two events, so we will apply this theorem, union and intersection. Okay? Any question here? Good. Good. Now, let's talk about assigning probability. What is assigning probability? Okay. Like usual, S is will be the sample. It's a sample space of an experiment with a finite or countable number of outcomes. Always we have will be here in assignment probability that S is finite number. ممنوع الانفينيتي, no infinity, okay? We assign a probability PS to each outcome S. We require that two conditions will be met. First condition, the probability of S always will be between 0 and 1, okay? And the summation of all probabilities of S will be 1. That is the probability, okay? Well, simple example. Suppose that a die is biased or loaded. Die is biased or loaded, okay? So that 3 appears twice as often as each other number, but other 5 outcomes are equally likely. يعني عنا زهر, عنا زهر لما صنعوا للزهر هذا الدايس او الداي لما تصنع بالويت صار في ايرور, صار في ايرور, there are error in the its weight, صار في جهه فيها بلاستيك اكثر من جهه وبتصير بالتصنيع. فالزهر لما ترميه انت هو في 6 نمبرز, لما ترميه شو البروبابيلتي حيلا رقم يطلع؟ يفترض 1 over 6. اوكي؟ واضحه هون؟ لما يكون balanced, لما يكون في عندنا balanced dice مش biased or loaded die, اوكي؟ مفروض يطلع كل وجه من هالنمبرز, كل فيس من هالداي, or اوكي؟ will be 1 over 6. We have 6 die, 6 number. Probability لحيلا رقم يطلع 1 على 6. اوكي؟ في حال كان في ديفو ايرور بالتصنيع مانيفاكتشر اوف داي وي كول ات از بايست اور امبالانسد اور لودد داي. سو باي اكسبيرمنت ذي نوتس ذات ذا نمبر 3 الجهه تبع الزهر على رقم 3 في بلاستيك اكثر او في بلاستيك اقل, بشكل انه كل ما ترميه لهالزهر عم بيطلع رقم ثلاثة مرتين أكثر من غيره. عم بيطلع probability تاعيته وكأنه 2 على 6 مش 1 على 6. أوكي؟ وكأنه 2 على 6. أوكي؟ مش أكثر من غيره. So, what is the probability that an odd number appears when we roll this die? عندنا الأرقام الـ odd هن الـ event will be 1, 3, 5. This is the 3 odd number. Okay? Okay? Sure probability lal odd number here. Because we have a 3 عنده مشكلة, we have a problem in number 3. So 3 will likely be double probability than others. So all the numbers 1, 2, 4, 5, 6 will be 1 over 7. Why we here we put 6 plus 1? Why we have 7? Anyone tell me? Why we have 7?
And 3 martin appears twice.
لأنه twice، لأنه three كأنه مرتين، كأنه وكأنه we have six numbers plus another number equal three, seven numbers, like we have seven numbers. So P1, P2, P4, P5, P6 will be 1/7 and probability of 3 will be 2/7. Okay, so here is simple. What is the probability of odd number will be probability of 1 plus probability of 3 plus probability of 5, which equals 1/7 plus 2/7 plus 1/7 equal 4/7. Okay, did you get it? Did you get it?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Here, we'll stop here. Okay, we'll stop here. We'll continue Thursday, this chapter. Okay? We'll stop recording here and continue next Thursday at the same time. Okay? Do you have any question in this till now?
No.
Do you have?
No.
It's easy. It's easy.